people always walk around with a chip on their shoulder because they're black, daring anybody to say anything to them. And our society has been hijacked and kidnapped and pushed into a corner where no one can say anything publicly about black people. If you do, they call you a racist and a bigot. So the true thoughts and true dialogue between white folk and black folk cannot go forward, because you cannot speak your mind or the truth without being called a racist if you say anything about the spirit of black folk, the habits of black folk, the spirit of black folk. Black men are full of abandonment, they're full of murder, they're full of robbery, and full of violence. Now, that's not to say that all black men are, but 70% of them are. 70% of them desert their children. 70% of them don't matter the mothers that follow the children through. 1 million of them are in prison. And this has nothing to do with white folk or slavery. So you can't. We can't have a true and meaningful dialogue about race in this nation, because if you say anything to black folk, you will be thrown out of town and out of church. Here's what I want to say to you as we go home to fight this battle. The first thing we're going to have to do, you've got to do what I'm doing. You got to stand up and not be worried about popular opinion or what people say about you or what people think about you. Black people got a chip on their shoulder. If you want to knock it off, knock it off. Knock that chip right off their shoulders. I mean, they knock chips off everybody else's shoulder. I mean, what is fair? It's fair. We got to get rid of what I refer to as affirmative black social affirmative action, the way we have to walk around eggshells, the way white people have to walk on eggshells around black people, on the job, in the church, and every place else. If you're white, you have to walk on white eggshells so that you don't offend these black people that wear their racism on their shoulder, their blackness on their shoulder, and they wear slavery on their sleeves. This has got to stop. It's hurting the black race, it is destroying the white race, and it's pulverizing our nation in terms of this relation, and working together united to be able to meet for a greater nation and even a greater church to give God the glory. I say unto you, stop, white people, stop walking on eggshells around black people. I mean, who are they anyway? You got to be so careful about everything you say, everything you do, every place you go, and every turnaround you got to hear slavery. Every other moment you got to hear something about slavery, or you got to hear something about police brutality. I mean, it just needs to stop. And black folk are not going to stop lapping this up and pushing you into a corner and bribing you and making you act like a misfit of you around them and having you so glad that you're no longer in their presence when you finally leave work or whatever else you are with them. You can finally relax and be yourself. This has got to stop, because it's destroying black people. It is giving them a false sense of security, making them think that they don't have to do anything to better their lives, that you are the cause of everything that's going wrong with them. Now, if you white folk are tired, if you're sick and tired of hearing black folk blame you for everything that's wrong with them, stop acting like you are wrong. You are the blame. You are the reason for everything that's wrong with black folk. You're not. So stop acting like it. Knock the chips off those black folk's shoulders and knock that slavery off their sleeves. And kill an alien and a boom shaka like go right there. Praise Almighty God, I'm Pastor James David Manning, and we're going to put